join us shortly. Our course is just now is very simple. It's on the lens is thinking, what do? The first thing we're going to do is to try and see how we are presented with a case where it is likely to sink and how we prevent it doing that. And the second stage is when you break the capsule and the lens starts to sink, and then what? That's what we're going to start off the whole course with. My name is Dr. Keki Mehta. I'm sure all of you know me. If you don't, now you know me. So that's fine. Now let's start off. Can we have the room lights a little low, please? Light doesn't go low. Sorry, light doesn't go low. Good, the screen is bright, doesn't make a difference. As the saying goes, some days are not so good. You start off in the morning, you are doing your cases, case looks to be reasonably fine, and you're wondering, everything seems to be fine, why are we worried? Still, it's a little hard cataract, so I didn't want to take a chance. When you are presented with a hard cataract, the safest thing is to just put in a bit of Tri-Pan Blue. Why? Not for any reason that you can't do that excess, but in case you break it one day, you will have enough of a capsule left over, identified easily, for you to put an anterior segment lens or a posterior chamber lens carefully put in. So whenever you have any doubt about your case, first stain the anterior capsule. Staining the anterior capsule has one more advantage which we don't often talk about, namely that it makes the capsule a little stiffer and therefore enables you to have a greater amount of resistance to its running away completely at all. As you notice, this is a little fibrotic capsule, and these fibrotic capsules are classically always associated also with a little weakened zonule somewhere or the other. So you are forewarned when you look at a case like this that this is a case which is likely to give me trouble. Okay, either way, you do your rexus, and the typical sign which you are seeing essentially is, if you see here at the sides, you see tractional bands occurring when you are doing rexus. When you do that, it indicates your capsule is a little loose. Again, an indication that you have got some weakness somewhere or the other. Till the present moment, it all seemed fine, nothing much. You do hydrodissection and then hydrodelineation, and then you proceed forwards. Since we are a little worried about it, we now use hydrodissection in two quadrants. First in the horizontal, apply just a little. Don't squirt it like a watering can. Then apply a little on the opposite pole. Then apply again horizontally. Don't go on squirting it everywhere, just in two planes, horizontal and then vertical. Do it systematically. The advantage of this is that it will, like when you want to cut a tree, you can decide where you want the edge to stand up off. When you inject at two planes, your lens will stand up on the plane opposite to where you have done it. Then you simply rotate it with that same little injector syringe that you use, which releases the adhesions in the lower part. So till the present moment, life is fine. We are not too worried. Everything seems to be okay. Okay, it was a little hard cataract. All right, nothing much. It's a grade 3. And we know that the zonules are a little loose somewhere. That's okay. Our people grow old. They don't always grow old gracefully. So once in a while, this is to be expected. Here we take it and we start chopping the nucleus up into little fragments. Just hold the nucleus and you do your chop running down the sides. As you notice, another little key point which tells you everything is not well is that the lens doesn't seem to remain stable. It tends to move a little. Again, a little key indicator which tells you something is happening somewhere, nothing to worry about. Still, everything is doing fine. You have broken your lens into little fragments, and now you are going to proceed on doing that. You will look at the figures at the side. The irrigation is low, the aspiration is low. We are literally doing what is known as slow motion phaco, letting everything run slowly rather than running fast. Now I want you to look in the upper side here, and after a certain amount of time you will find that changes start to appear in that zone which you didn't really want. Till the moment there's no hassles. I have left this as it is so that you are aware that there has been no sudden traction or pull which has precipitated whatever is going to precipitate soon. Final fragments are going away peacefully again, running very slow, not using too much of phaco power, not doing much. and just getting the last few fragments out. When the last few fragments are left, just tickle your edge of your phaco, lift it up and down, move it a little, and that usually lets the fragments go in easily. Once this part is done, then comes the next interesting part, which we have to now look up and see what is happening. Up to the present moment, it's all seemed to be fine, but as I showed you in that little area on top, see the final amounts of the cortex is going away, there's no problem. And as we start aspirating, you notice now the tear which has happily occurred in this side here. Not that we looked for it, not that we did it, we were careful, we did everything by the book. Now comes the next question, what are we going to do? The answer is very simple. At this stage, the important thing is not to lose control over what you are doing. Inject in viscoelastic from the opposite pole and unroll your capsule which has started coming out. You try any further games and you will just aspirate your entire lens out. Fortunately, the fragments have not come loose. Otherwise, we'd have fun with that. So the next thing is very simple. You push in a ring to stabilize it. You can either use this disposable unit which is made in Delhi, or you can utilize the Greuter one which I use. For this case, we have used the disposable one. And the important thing about it is always apply it with the point squeezing the edge in and then letting it unravel out. The advantage of that is it holds that part in, not preventing it slipping outwards. So you turn it and the last final bit, you lift it a little at the edge and you drop it in. An easier way of doing that is to use a repositor from the opposite pole, which stabilizes it and enables your final fragment to drop in into its proper place. You know it has dropped into the proper place because it has become again symmetrical and round. If it had not dropped in, the lower part would be unsymmetrical at all. It's an easy way to do it. Now you have to go and now you're seeing little strands of vitreous starting to cup, which I am cutting off, indicating that vitreous is now disturbed and we are now getting in difficulty. So we inject a little bit more of viscoelastic into this place just to settle it down. Viscoelastic, as I said, is your poor man's friend. When you are in trouble, that's usually the only guy who stands with you. And you inject in your intraocular implant. Again, the important thing is you rotate it in the plane opposite to where your dislocated area was and let the other area fall on the dislocated zone and act as a point. Now you do vitrectomy. Remove the point here. At this stage, you can also inject in a bit of additional units which tell you as to how you are getting along at this point, namely your methylprednisolone, which you inject in, which will stain the vitreous bands. The last fragments, try and remove utilizing your cutter, but with the cutter off, utilizing it as an aspirating mode. That way, in case at any stage you find that your vitreous has started to come, you can activate the cutter at that time. So keep the cutter under your foot rather than trying to aspirate it off. So at this stage, you can manage to get away. So though you have broken the face, had been presented with a large subluxated zone, you can manage, usually if you are a little careful, to get away with a lot and get your lens back into its proper place. As I mentioned earlier, one of the advantages of our doing the staining was that it told us essentially as to which are the edges where you want your lens to go under. And you can notice that now the lens is stabilized well. Now let's go on to the next one. Go to the next video, please. Now comes the problem that if you have broken it, if you have broken it, then what are we now going to do? So this is the stage at which we use something which I call as a HEMA lifeboat, which has also been worked on further by Amar. And this was a long video which originally won at the IIR, at one of the APACRS meetings. And we use this, there is no financial implication in the products. This is when we are proceeding with a nice peaceful phaco. As I said, phaco is a nice quiet procedure, but sometimes, especially when there is a hard cataract, things don't do well. Vitreous starts to come out, you know you are in trouble. Long before you start dropping your fragments, always look for this little telltale sign, I call it the wit sign. And this is often a quandary. Now what to do? You got these large pieces sitting there, and the answer is very simple. You take a little ring of HEMA, which is cut to 9.5 millimeters. Basically, it's a HEMA lens. You place it in the middle, you roll it over, and you inject it inside the eye. This is a standard 5.5 diopter plus 5.5 diopter contact lens, which you just keep in stock with you. No real great thing about it. And all you have to do is tuck it into an injector. You all have injectors lying with you. Any injector works out. There's really no hassle. Then you subsequently use this and you inject it inside the eye. What you are trying to do with the 9.5 is it sits on the iris. Move your fragments to the side and inject this little HEMA lens of yours onto the anterior surface of the iris. Once it goes on this plane, then you stack the fragments onto that HEMA fragment which you made, like putting people onto a lifeboat. So you just move the fragments onto the surface. Just move them onto the surface. And after having moved to the surface, the next step is you do your regular phacoemulsification. If you use a plus 5.5 diopter one, then the lens is stable enough that it will support almost normal phacoemulsification with a little reduced irrigation. No risk of any fragment going in, nothing to worry about. It just stays there. It is rock stable. So your fragments can be easily removed. At this point, you can, once you have removed all the fragments, now you know that you are safe. You're only left with a little of lens inside, and see how the HEMA sits. You simply hold it and you simply tug it out. The HEMA comes out easily enough. I'll put it onto the cornea just to show you what it looks like on the surface. This has also been made now by Care Group, so you can always pick it up if you want to make it, take it ready-made. But if you're lazy about it, use a 9.5 millimeter punch on a 5 plus 5 diopter contact lens. This is how it looks when it sits onto the cornea. And at this stage, of course, you can just manage simply. Looking at a short animation of this, how we've done this, is you got this contact lens, you shove it into this folder, like I showed it a little earlier. You put it in, fold it twice, fold once, then fold it over. It's like two hands folded over your chest. Otherwise, it doesn't come out correct. So remember to do it that way. Fold it over, one hand over the other. Close the lid, and then simply inject it in. Inject it at the side, and with your repositor, slide your fragments onto the surface. This is all that we need to do, slide it into the holder and then you push it into the side, and you get your fragments which you can then slide and put onto the surface without much of a difficulty. So the fragments come onto the surface which you can phaco off. It's a very simple concept. Amar has built on the concept very well, I must say. He puts in the lens, he takes it one step faster so that you can then do your phaco over the lens itself, bypassing one step. But the advantage of using this step is that it completely blocks the opening, so nothing can slip anywhere from behind. So I mean, it enables you to run safely, and once subsequent to that, then the simplest thing is you just remove this fragment and you can then do an IA aspiration or do a core vitrectomy and remove it out. But removal, because it's a HEMA, it's a very thin lens, comes out easily with no hassles. You just throw it away, costs you almost nothing. And just as one for the last few seconds, last 2 minutes, just showing you once more how the lifeboat works. Again, a break occurring. And again, you get your little, what I call is a wit sign. A little vitreous at the side tells you, hey, we are in trouble. Inject a bit of viscoelastic at the side and inject your little lifeboat in. Basically, the lens, as I said. Open it, unfurl it using a repositor, and let your fragments just come over it. Just let your fragments come over it. Once that is there, I can assure you, nothing goes back. It is as rock stable. Aram se feko karo, no further thought required. Peacefully do it. And once that is over, then you can just have to just remove the, once your fragments are out completely, you are no longer worried about anything else. The rest can be easily managed. You can do a little core vitrectomy if you wish to. Remove all the fragments, remove the vitreous, using a bit of steroids into the eye to make sure you can delineate the pieces which are there, and in case there's a requirement, and then you can just clear it off. There's really no hassles. And one advantage you can here I'm just doing, rather than going further, because the fragments have not been disturbed at all, I just do visco dissection, which works out very easily. And then you inject your implant over the repositor so that the repositor supports your lens as you go in, and that will enable it to work very easily. Again, letting it go anterior to the anterior capsule on both sides, so you can, though you have broken the face, you can still manage to get a perfect venue. So that is essentially how this system works. We'll talk about it a little later, but in the meantime, let me invite Dr. Ramamurthy, who is now going to talk to you on his technique on how he handles these sort of problems and affairs. As you're aware, Dr. Ramamurthy from the Eye Foundation, our past president, an extraordinary surgeon, an exemplary clinician, has managed to do a number of new techniques. Let us see how he handles his things. Please, Dr. Ramamurthy.